discussion of the gluteal region. This is the left side of the gluteal region. On that side, over the right side, you can see the gluteal region. It divides into the four quadrant by the to draw the line from the midlines. It is the upper and lateral, upper and medial, lower and lateral, and lower and medial. So, upper and lateral quadrant. This quadrant, which is cutaneous nerve distributions by the subcostal and iliohypogastric nerve, upper and medial quadrants, which is supplied by the perforating branch of the L1, L2, L3, as well as S1, S2, S3. So upper and medial, lower and lateral quadrant. This quadrant, it is supplied by the lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh, and lower and medial quadrant, which is supplied by the posterior cutaneous nerve of the thigh. So the fiber of the posterior cutaneous nerve of the thigh, which wind round over the gluteal gluteus maximus, lower border of the gluteus maximus, and it supplies to the cutaneous distribution over the lower and medial side of the thigh. So this is a cutaneous distribution. Now we will discuss about the first muscles. We have reflected the skin, superficial fascia, deep fascia, and now you can see this is a gluteus maximus muscles. It is the largest muscles of the gluteal region, which arise from the, here you can see this gluteal muscles, gluteus maximus, which arise from the posterior gluteal line and area behind to the posterior gluteal line, as well as the outer dorsal aspect of the iliac crest. And this portion and area behind to the posterior gluteal line, this is the whole area which is gives the origin of the gluteus maximus, as well as it attach on the lateral quadrant of the outer surface of the sacrums, coccyx, and there is also attachment of the sacrotuberous ligament. Here there is a sacrotuberous ligament. It also gives the origin of the gluteus maximus. So the gluteus maximus, which is arise from the lateral margin of the sacrum, coccyx, sacrotuberous ligaments, dorsal aspect of the outer quadrant of the iliac crest, posterior gluteal line, and area behind to the posterior gluteal line on the ilium, it is the origin of the gluteus maximus. And this gluteus maximus, which is inserted on the this is the gluteal tuberosity on the femur, this is the insertion of the gluteus maximus. Here you can see this is the gluteus maximus. We have reflected, you can see it is inserted on the gluteal tuberosity, as well as it is inserted on the iliotibial tract on the lateral aspect of the it is the thickening of the fascia lata on the lateral aspect. It gives the insertion of the gluteus maximus as well as tensor fascia lata. Now we have reflected the gluteus maximus, and you can see there is a muscles the piriformis. It is the main demarcating muscles, the structure passing below to the greater sciatic foramen, below to the piriformis, and above to the piriformis. Now the gluteus maximus, which is supplied by the inferior gluteal nerve and vessels. Here you can see these are the inferior gluteal nerve and vessels. This is the vein, this is the artery, and these are the nerves. Here you can see this, the nerve, which is divided into the many branches, and it innervate to the whole of the gluteus maximus. So it is the chief extensor muscles of the hip joint. It is a gluteus maximus. Another muscles, here you can see this is a gluteus medius. This is a gluteus medius. You can see this gluteus medius, which arise from the between the area between the on the ilial ilium on the outer surface, between the posterior gluteal line and between the anterior gluteal line, this area, whole area, it is the origin of the gluteus medius. And this gluteus medius, which is inserted, there is a oblique line. This is the oblique line on the greater trochanter. It is the insertion of the gluteus medius. Another muscle, this is the gluteus minimus here between the anterior gluteal line, and this is the inferior gluteal line. This area, it gives the gluteus minimus, and it gives the insertion on the anterior aspect of the greater trochanter, anterior to the oblique line. It gives the insertion of the gluteus minimus. So here you can see, inside the dissection, we have reflect the gluteus maximus. It arises from the between the posterior and anterior gluteal line, and it is inserted. Here you can see this muscle, which is inserted on the greater trochanter on the oblique line, and below to it, it is, you can see this muscle below to it. This is the gluteus minimus, which arises from the anterior gluteal line and inferior gluteal line, and it is inserted also on the greater trochanter, anterior to the oblique line of the greater trochanter. It gives the insertion of the gluteus minimus muscles. Both the muscles, which is supplied by the superior gluteal vessels and nerves. This is the superior gluteal vessels and nerves. So superior gluteal vessels and nerves, which arise from the greater sciatic foramen above to the piriformis. This is the piriformis, and it arises from the above to the piriformis, and it innervate the gluteus medius as well as gluteus minimus, and it also innervate to the tensor facial arta muscles. So this is about to the three gluteal muscles. Now we will discuss about the here you can see, this is the sacrotuberous ligaments. This sacrotuberous ligament, you can see, it is arise from the outer margin of the sacrum to the ischial tuberosity. This is the ischial tuberosity, and below it there is a three structure which is lies from medial to laterals. Here you can see, this is the interpudental nerve. This is the first interpudental nerve, and this is the interpudental artery and veins, and this one is the nerve to obturator internus. This is the nerve to obturator internus. So these are the three structure which is below to the sacrotuberous ligament, but it is above to the sacrospinous ligament. This is the sacrospinous ligament, and sacrospinous ligament, it arises from the sacrum to the ischial spine. It is the sacrospinous ligaments, and the just below to the piriformis muscles, you can see, this is the piriformis muscles. There is a thickest nerve inside the body. It is a sciatic nerve. The sciatic nerve, which is formed by the two nerve, there is a tibial component as well as the common peroneal component. Tibial component, which is formed by the ventral rami, ventral root of the ventral rami of the L4, L5, S1, S2, S3, and common peroneal component, which is formed by the dorsal division of L4, L5, S1, S2. And it together it forms the sciatic nerve. It is the thickest nerve inside the body, and it divide at the upper two-third and lower third of the thigh. It divide into the tibial and common peroneal nerve. Just below to the sciatic nerve which is passes through the greater sciatic foramen, it enter inside the thigh or gluteal region. Then it enter between the, this is the ischial tuberosity, and this is the greater trochanter. In between there is a area, this is the groove. The in between it passes above to the lateral rotator muscles. Mainly this is the superior gamuli. Here you can see, this is the tendon of the superior gamuli, and this one is the inferior gamuli, and in between there is a white color tendon. It is the obturator internus muscles, and this one is the quadratus femoris. So the sciatic nerve, which is passes above to the all these four lateral rotator, mainly the superior gamuli, obturator internus, inferior gamuli, and now to quadratus femoris muscles, and then it enter into the between the hamstring muscles. The laterally, the it is the long and sorted of biceps femoris, and medially it is by the semitendinosus and semimembranosus muscles, and it enter inside the back of the thigh, and it divide into the TPL and common peroneal nerve. Now we will discuss about the this is the superior gamelli. Here you can see this is a superior gamelli. This superior gamelli, which arise from the upper margin of the ischial spine, otherwise ischial lesser sciatic foramen, upper margin, it gives the origin of the superior gamelli, and the lower margin of the lesser sciatic foramen, it gives the origin of the inferior gamelli. And obturator internus, which arise inner side of the around to the obturator foramen, the muscles which arise the obturator internus, and it passes the tendon which is passes right angle through the lesser sciatic foramen, which is converted by the lesser sciatic foramen, which is converted lesser sciatic notch converted into the foramen by the sacrospinous ligament. And this obturator internus, which passes through the lesser sciatic notch, and it is inserted on the greater trochanter at the upper margin with the two gamelli. It gives the insertion of the superior gamelli, inferior gamelli, and obturator internus. All these muscles, which is inserted into the upper margin and the inner margin of the greater trochanter of the femurs. So it is the insertion of these three muscles, and these muscles, here you can see there is a nerve to obturator this is the nerve to obturator internus. Here you can see this is the nerve to obturator internus, and nerve to obturator internus along with it, this is the interimpudental nerve, and this is the interimpudental artery, and nerve to obturator internus. This is the structure passes greater sciatic foramen to the lesser sciatic foramen, and this nerve to obturator internus supplies to the superior gamelli as well as it supplies to the obturator internus. Another nerve just below to the sciatic nerve, here you can see this nerve, it passes deep to the superior gamelli, obturator internus, and this nerve, it is nerve to quadratus femoris, and this nerve to quadratus femoris, which supplies to the inferior gamelli as well as it supplies to the quadratus femoris muscles. So these quadratus femoris muscles, which arise from the outer part of the ischial tuberosity on inner side, and it is inserted on the quadrate tubercle between the lesser and greater trochanter of the femur, and it is inserted on the quadrate tubercle. It is the insertion of the quadratus femoris. So piriformis, superior gamelli, obturator internus, inferior gamelli, and quadratus femoris, these are the short muscles, which are the contraction of these muscles, it lead to there is a lateral rotations of the femur. So it is the lateral rotator of the thigh. So piriformis, superior gamelli, obturator internus, inferior gamelli, and quadratus femoris, these are the five muscles are the lateral rotator of the thigh. Here you can see the another nerve, which is coming deep to the it supplies to the piriformis muscle, it is nerve to piriformis. So this is the nerve to piriformis. Now again we will in brief we will discuss the structure inside the gluteal region. This is the gluteus maximus, we have caught from the origin, and the nerve and vessels which is goes inside the gluteus maximus, it is the inferior gluteal vessels and nerves. And the most demarcating muscle, it is the piriformis, and structure passes above to the piriformis and below to the piriformis. This is the gluteus medius, and this one is the gluteus minimus. Gluteus medius and minimus are supplied by the superior gluteal vessels and nerves. It is formed by the posterior division of L4, L5, S1 and inferior gluteal nerve, which is formed by the L5 S1 S2. This one is the sacrospinous ligament. We have got the sacrospinous ligament. You can see reflect the sacrospinous ligament. The structure, it is the interpudental nerve, interpudental artery, and this is the nerve to obturator internus. This is the sciatic nerve, and this one is the posterior cutaneous nerve of the thigh. And these are the, this is the piriformis. The piriformis, which is arise from the sacrum, from the three inverted E shape, there is a origin of the piriformis from the second, third and fourth sacral vertebra, and it is and this piriformis, which is inserted on the medial surface of the greater trochanter, inside the trochanteric fossa, there is a insertion of the piriformis muscles. Also over the tip of the greater trochanter, it gives the insertion of the piriformis. So this is the nerve to piriformis. This one is the sciatic nerve, and here you can see this is the sacral plexus of the sacral part of the sciatic nerve, and this one is the lumbar part of the sciatic nerve. So this is about to the gluteal region, and you can see the all the muscles of the gluteal region, as well as the axon, mainly the gluteus maximus, it is the chief extensor, gluteus medius and minimus are the chief abductor muscles. If there is a paralysis of this gluteus medius and minimus, there is a positive Trillenberg signs, because it does not elevate to the, whenever we can run, walk at that time, it cannot elevate the opposite height of the pelvis. So there is a lurching and wading gaits which is seen. It is also, it may be occur due to the dislocation of the hip joints, there is a presence of the lurching and wading gaits. So even in avascular necrosis of the head of the femur, you can see the lurching and wading gaits. But mainly you have to identify either it is the paralysis of the gluteus medius or minimus, either dislocation of the hip joint, either it may be avascular necrosis of the femur, it lead to there is a lurching and wading gaits. So this one is the gluteus maximus, this is the medius, this one is the minimus, these are the superior gluteal vessels, this is the inferior gluteal vessels, this is the posterior cutaneous nerve of the thigh, this one is the sciatic nerve, this one is the below to the sciatic superior gamuli, this one is the obturator internus, and this one is the inferior gamuli, quadratus femoris, and sacrotuberous ligament, and structure below to the sacrotuberous ligament, interpudental nerve, pudental vessels, and nerve to obturator internus. This one is the piriformis muscles. It divides the greater sciatic foramen into the two parts, superior part, structure above to the piriformis, and structure below to the piriformis. So this is about to the gluteal region.